What is up, guys? This is Chap, and welcome back to some more Connected Franchise. This week, we are actually going to play two games, and I'm going to do one of the practices. I just don't feel like it's right for me to sit and waste maybe 10 minutes of your guys' time doing both the practices. Instead, I'll only waste about half that. So let's go ahead and take on the Browns. After we play the Browns, we will do the practice for next week, and then play whatever game that might be next week. So let's go ahead and do this, taking on the Cleveland Browns. We might only be in for like the first quarter, maybe the first half. Probably the first quarter. Because it's only the second game. Maybe, actually it might not even be the first quarter. It might only be like one or two drives still. I think the third game, we would stay in for the first quarter. Or would it be into the, I don't know. I forget how it works. I know the last game you play an entire half, pretty much. Week 3. I think week 3 is a quarter and a little bit, and I think this week 2 game is just a quarter. I think. I might be wrong, though. Because this is preseason. This isn't regular season.
Hello, friends. Jim Nantz along with Phil Sims. Just prior to kickoff for this primetime extravaganza, and this adds another whole layer of excitement when you have this game under the lights.
Yeah, it makes it more exciting for the fans. It builds up their enthusiasm because they're out there tailgating all day, getting ready for the game, but also for the players.
So let's do it. Am I still the kick returner? I forgot since last episode. Am I still the kick? I know. I guess 89, Mark Mariani.
Well, I think we're going to see a lot of excitement.
Mariani is the kick returner. That was a not bad kick return. That was not bad. If he could have broke that last tackle on, I think it was 55, he could have had a good chance there. I got Payne 2 Super Bowl rings too, so he's quite an icon. Gonna block this guy. I have good blocking, honestly. Welker getting 14 there. Is Welker lining up outside this year? I haven't been paying attention to that.
I don't think this defense has that kind of quality
corner. I don't really know what he's doing. I'm blocking again regardless. He hits Tammy. Tammy does like a crazy juke move on 54 there. I think that was Carlos Dansby, actually. A lot of play action here. This is a deep play. Yeah, Welker is lined up outside this year, apparently. I haven't really seen much of Brandon Lloyd. If he hits Dries in there to the right, he went to Welker. Welker almost came down with it, too.
This defensive front has been the talk all week long. And Phil, we met with them.
Okay, this could be a good run. It just depends how Dreesen plays it. Dreesen played it pretty well. Except for Welker really didn't block anyone.
This defense you're playing against.
Okay, got to take a punt.
So it's fourth down near midfield. Punt the football.
Stevens howling. Why is Stevens howling? Like, how would he get the kick return job? I would assume there's a lot better receivers than Stevens. Howling's a running back. I'd assume there's a lot better receivers than him that are faster that could do that job way better. I'm trying to say. This is gonna be the year, guys. This is gonna be the year Monty finally returns a kick. Promise you this. This year, I will do it sometime. Sometime this year, Monty is going to take a kick. Just better not get shoelace tackled on the way, and I'll be good. Ronnie Hillman. This is a beautiful year because it's basically me and Ronnie all year. Because we cut Noshon. We cut Noshon last year, actually. We cut Peyton Hills this year, so I don't got to deal with him, at least. So it's me and Ronnie, which is awesome. I'm elusive. I got to give Monty that. Like, a tiny little cut or a tiny little move like that, and he can elude people pretty well. Three rushes, 24 yards, but you got to think it's basically two for 24 because one only got back to the line of scrimmage.
Jackson is able to bring him down.
Got four there, which is good. Moving the ball, Payne's liking me, so maybe I'll actually get more rushing yards this year.
The Broncos all bunched up here as they get set at the line. Peyton Manning looking
just completely overthrows 86 there. Was that Virgil Green? No? I don't know who 86 is. 42-yard field goal, okay. Am I out for the game, maybe? No, we're still in it, so we're still in it.
No question about that decision. Here comes the punting team.
Got a bit of a sore throat this morning. Okay, this is going to be it. I feel this kick. I feel it.
Wants to give it a go here.
Stiff arm in the air, just because I can. That almost worked. I get good punt returns regardless, though. Like, for this being all Madden, I get pretty good punt returns. For only 86 speed, I do pretty well for myself. I haven't returned a kick in so long, I don't even imagine myself with, like, a 95 or a 96 speed player. I'd be pretty good at punt returns, I'd like to think. I'm doing a wheel route here, so.
Manning from the gun. He'll fire it out.
Wide open.
Nifty move past the defender. Well, when you keep chipping away with these short throws,
that's the end of the first. So let's see. We've played a first, but let's see if we continue playing. I don't think we will. I think we're going to be out now.
Take a break as the first quarter comes to a close here in
we played an entire quarter game number two.
Offense here to start the second quarter.
Am I in? No, okay, we aren't in. So it is only a quarter game number two. Osweiler drove and scored 10 points for us so far. Good job, Osweiler. Another 3 points. They got three. Looking like we're actually going to win this game, though. He got a touchdown as well. Nice. So did... Okay, GG. Nice game, Osweiler. Nice game. 19 points scored.
You've often talked about prime time and how the players of
so let's get out of here. We had a not bad game. Like, that was probably one of the better games we had rushing. We only got, like, 4 or 5 carries, but we had, like, a 6 or 7 yard average per carry, which is probably, like, one of our best when we've been playing here. Though saying this was only preseason, it didn't count for anything, but we were playing pretty good there. Okay, we got like 200 XP or something like that for that game. So let's go ahead, advance, play our next week's practice and our next week's game. And yeah, move on to week 3. Okay, there we go. Advancing week. So let's go ahead and do this practice here. We'll do the down by two, I believe. As soon as it loads here. We're going to be playing the 49ers. Okay, that's going to be a challenge. I'm going to like that game. Let's do our practice, though, first. Get a hopefully 1,000 or 2,000 XP. 2,000 would be the best, since 1,000 is the worst we could get. But we have a pretty good legacy, too. 879. Only being in the league 1 year is pretty good. Thinking that most legends are around like 12,000, something like that. 879 is pretty good. I want to be known more of a running back, though. I don't want to be known as this receiving back because I get so many damn receiving yards, but I don't get many rushing attempts because we have Peyton under center. I'd like to run the ball more, but 4th and 10, let's do it. Corner strike like we always do. I guess I have to be the one who tries to get it like always. He's going to throw to me or Dreesen. Can I tell Dreesen to F off? I can. Okay. I didn't even get it. If he threw to Dreesen, he wouldn't have got the first down anyway, so that's why. That was my plan, and GG. GG. GG game. As soon as we get the ball, I'm just going to punt it away. Down by 9. Impossible to come back with a minute 58 and no timeouts. You can't do it. You could do it. You could, but the chances of you getting that onside recovery are very slim, and especially you not eating enough time, or eating too much time. Mariani breaks this, but he gets shoelaced like I did. Exactly how I got tackled, too. We'll do one good play here. One good play. If he can hit any of these deep passes, I will think we might have a chance. We can't even call a timeout here. I probably should not have done that. Because we still would have a chance if I didn't... Or he could still hit someone deep here again. And that could help us quite a bit. He hits Sanders here again. He led Sanders so much there. He led Sanders so much. He was wide open if he just threw it at him. But he led him. Okay. Yeah, they recovered it. Wait. They recovered it. Oh my god. No. It's going to go through the end zone though. My guy's not going to... Oh, okay. Here comes the challenge here. I might get a chance to return this if he doesn't drill through my end zone. If he drills into my end zone, my computer is going to try to run away from it, so I'm going to have to go manually catch it. And thirdly, I have to take this for 6 if we want to win the game. If we want to win the practice, at least. If I want my 2K XP, this has to go to the house. My guy is going to try to return it. We're going to try to go right here. Oh, 22 got off the block. 43, come on. Didn't give me enough blocking. We had 1K XP, though. That's not too bad. I don't really care about preseason, so... As soon as we get to the regular season, the more receiving rushing yards we get in the game, that's going to be our main source of XP. Preseason's more or less just get it over with, I guess. So let's go into week number 3 here. I might actually even play week 4 here. Depending how quick this game goes, if we have enough time, I might just skip the practice of the preseason week number 4. And play that game, get it over with, and then for next episode we could start the regular season. But I want to see exactly how long this game takes here. On 11 football. Not been obtained. Or had not been achieved, sorry. Previous games. I've actually never used the precision stiff arm. I've used the regular stiff arm. I've never used precision. I don't even know what the precision stiff arm is. I always just hold X personally to stiff arm. I never combine it with L2. I'm gonna have to try that. Cause I don't really know what it does.
Hello, friends. Jed Nance, along with Phil
I'm used
Sim.
To the old just controls of previous Maddens, not this new precision crap.
Adds another whole layer of excitement when you have this game under the lights.
Yeah, it makes it more exciting for the fans.
Weren't we in Sports Authority last game? Do we have back-to-back home games, possibly? I might be wrong, but I thought it was a home game last week.
All you can think about is the game.
Let's go right here, Mariani. Or just kneel it. That works, too. Okay. Sure, Mariani.
NFL MVP quarterback Peyton Manning.
This could work very good for me because I think the guy who's going to be on me is a linebacker, but it is zone. And I am wide open, but he hits Demaryius. Because everyone was doing streaks on that side. If it was man coverage, I was uncovered there. I can't tell if I have a receiving route because Peyton's name is in my way. I did. He hits Lloyd. Lloyd drops it. I don't know. Is Lloyd the slot receiver? He is. Okay. That's kind of fucked up. Lloyd, I think at least. I'd be wrong just because it's a bunch formation, but person catches it at least. Next we're going to see here is Welker going to be lined up outside, which I think he is. He is. So they have Lloyd as the slot receiver, not Welker.
After that completion, trying to get it outside.
22, you are terrible. Screw you, 22. Jacob Hester, leave the team. Damn, he ran for no one. He was like trying to get the safety there, but he didn't know where the safety went, so he just kept running. Fuck. God damn it, Jacob Hester. He just keeps running. Just keeps running for nothing. Yeah, they threw a pick, correct? I think they did. They threw a pick. A pick six, I think. And then they got it back, and they have to putt now. This is going to go through the end zone, unfortunately. Yep.
They'll take it at the 20.
Yeah, Wilker is the outside receiver this year. He took Decker's job. Emmanuel Sanders is going to have a big year, apparently, because Peyton Lake's hitting the guy. He's like 81 or something overall. He's pretty good, too. So I'm definitely good, fine with that. I'm just not really a big fan of these kill plays that Peyton has been running this year, where Peyton has basically thrown pass into an uncatchable situation where the receiver's just going to get murdered. Like that, kind of. Willis was looking to kill Welker there. If the other guy didn't pull him down, if the corner or safety didn't pull him down, Willis was going to finish the job there.
Hester's going to secure the handoff. Good job by the offensive line there on third and short. Even though the defense knew it was probably going to be a run, still able to get in there.
Okay, so are we going to be in this game a bit more? It's the end of the first, so it's either we're going out now or we're going to get like one more drive. Looks like we're out. Yeah, we are out. Okay, so it's only a quarter. So looking like we will play week number four of the preseason here, since this is a quicker game as well. Looking like we might win it, though. No, we're not going to win it. Nope. Oh, yes. Okay, late heroics there. But Brock Osweiler. Mariani, okay.
There it
Let's
is.
Get out of here.
The game has come to an end. It was a good one throughout. Hotly contested right down to the wire. Well, it's a big performance.
So I guess we're going to get the rest of the preseason done here. We'll go on to week number four, get that finished. Then be done with the preseason and be back to one-game episodes again. One game and one practice episodes again. So we'll start week one next episode. We're going to finish week four right now. And yeah, I've used the precision modifier dive. I've never used the stiff arm, never used the juke, if there is a juke. Never used anything like that, though. Just the dive I've used the precision modifier on. Okay, so let's go ahead, week number four, see who we got to play here. Who have we played so far? I don't even remember. We've played the 49ers, we've played... This is so long ago already, I've already forgotten. I have no idea. We're playing the Jaguars now, I guess. But, yeah, I can't even remember who we played in week two. We just played that game, I've already forgotten. Who do we play? I have no idea. I thought it was a team with a red uniform because Lerod Stevens-Howling was their kick returner. Was it like the... No. It was the Browns, I think. I'm pretty sure. I could be wrong. I think it was the Browns and we just played the 49ers and now we're taking on the Jaguars. So that's kind of a weird preseason schedule there. Browns, 49ers, Jaguars. Okay, So this game, we're going to play the entire first half. So a bit longer here. There's Blaine Gabbert, number 11.
And the Jaguars.
This is a perfect game here, because this video I'm planning on uploading as soon as the Broncos game is done today. So yeah, this is like a perfect matchup here. We get to see what happens in this game and then compare it to what happens in real life. I think the Broncos are going to destroy the Jaguars today, but we're going to see. We're going to see at least how we do here and then compare it. What if I just nailed it perfectly? The score was just perfect. God damn it, Monty. I had to drop it. There was no blocking there. I was only going to get like 5 yards, but still dropped it.
Peyton Manning. Wide receivers are bunched up. Looking for an open receiver on the
Dreesen. Dreesen's going to get a lot of receiving this year, too. Because Julius Thomas is no longer a factor. Him and Tammy just robbed Julius of his job when Julius played amazing. Shy Ronnie, straight dropping it.
Here's a look at the offensive unit. It needs to get off to a strong start today. Lloyd's in the slot. Manning's back in shotgun formation.
I was wide open there, but Demaryius, like an insta-cut move there. If Dreesen actually blocked someone there. That was crazy. He caught it, and he so quickly was turning and running. It was insane. The second he caught it, he was already gone.
Defense, you can be a little more aggressive now because you don't have to worry about the length of the field. It is
okay, Lloyd getting a couple maybe if he didn't stay in bounds, though.
This defensive front is so often disrupted and in the quarterback's
face. I thought the announcer said this defensive front is so awful, but he's saying they're disruptive. Okay, I thought he was just saying they were awful, but okay. That's a good way to describe them, but didn't think he would be that blatant, and he wasn't at least.
Well, that's a sign of a good defense. When you can sack the quarterback, when you're just rushing the defensive lineman, you don't need any tricks, you don't need any blitzes. Man, that's talent. Second and goal from the 9. He's looking
wide open there.
On this throw. Touchdown, Broncos.
First TD of the preseason, I believe, there. We might have got one actually earlier. Brian DeWapuente giving us celebration. Jaguars not doing anything. Back-to-back 3-and-outs for the Jaguars to start the game. Yeah, up 7-0 here. I don't think Monty Ball is going to catch the touchdown in real life just because he doesn't get too much playing time, but you never know. Because he did not block that one guy. There was one guy on my blocking team there that could have blocked one of those outside guys, but instead he like ran through him. He might have blocked like the punter or something.
In the slot. Balls got it.
I had nowhere to go there, but I got like 4. That's good.
When you're an offensive lineman and you can line up and just run the football straight ahead and pick up those kind of yards, you are going to get into the head of the defense. You're basically saying we're tougher than you are. And we're just gonna
wide open
right
Dreesen there.
He stacked up
again. Dreesen's going to have a good year this year.
That's a nice job by the offense there.
Unfortunately, I hope he gets hurt. I hope him and Tammy both come down with season-ending injuries so we see Julius again. But I don't think that's going to happen very likely. Demaryius is a crazy route here. He's a double option play. What is he going to do? Going to the... I don't know how Lloyd can't catch that. Isn't he like isn't he like 86 or something? 85, 86 on our team? I don't think I've seen him catch a pass yet this preseason. And we're already out of the game. We only played a quarter. They're not even doing the whole real life thing because they know we're playing the Jaguars here. And the Jaguars are beating us. They're kicking our ass. They're not even just beating us. The Jaguars won. I hope that doesn't happen in real life. If the Jaguars won 21-19, That's a sad day for all of us. It could happen. I don't think it's likely. I think there's like a 99% chance that it doesn't happen like that. But it could. There's still a 1% chance the Jaguars could do something amazing and win the game. So there we go. We lost. We're 2-2 in the preseason. Let's go ahead and advance. Jaguars kicked our butt. And yeah, that's sometimes you gotta take a loss to the Jaguars. Sometimes you just gotta give them a bit of confidence for the regular season. Because if we let them win there, they're gonna feel good about themselves in the regular season. Even if they lose all games. I mean all games. They're going to feel good about themselves. Even if they go 0-16, they can look back and say the one bright spot of their entire season, they beat the Super Bowl champions 21-19. So, just giving them a little bit of motivation there. I don't have a draft class to import, so no thank you. But I hope you guys enjoyed. Peace out, guys. Thanks for watching.